On this episode of Vintage Vaults, I will be discussing the Codename Sector board game. This is an electronic board game made by Parker Brothers. The object of the game is to strategically search for and destroy a submarine which is hidden somewhere in the waters that you are to be navigating. It's an electronic-based game, but with some manual grid-based tracking system that uses a straight line and a crayon to track positions and allow you to map out the path to the submarine that you're looking for. It uses an electronic display, series of buttons to program into the computer, and an electronic compass to give you an idea of where the sub may be based on your deductive skills and reasoning. Now let's open up this box and see what's inside. Inside the box, we have the game unit, which is mostly a plastic play field, which consists of a grid of ocean, along with some markers here indicating latitude and longitude, 30 north, 35 north, 40 north. These are just for references to help you play the game. There's also starting points that the ships start with. These are your ships that you use to try to find the sub. It's four ships. It could be you and three other players, or it can just be all you using four ships to try to triangulate the position. On the top end of the game is the LED display indicating ship speed, north and east locations, the depth of the sub, and the range of the sub. Those will all come in later. A LED compass, single lights for all the standard directions, and then two lights will light to indicate northeast, southeast, and all the other positions. Then there's a combat information center, which lets you select the next ship to track, button to help you move the ship, steering buttons, basically all the controls needed to navigate your ships to home in onto the submarine that's secretly hidden. Now, it's not physically hidden on the play field. It's secretly hidden, stored as a value in the computer. Underneath here is all the game playing equipment and the battery connector. There's a sub, another sub, a cleaning cloth, a well-used cleaning cloth to clean up the, if you make a mistake on the lines that you draw on the ocean. Set of official Codename Sector navigation crayons. These are four different colors, so you can keep track of the four different ships. This allows you to draw the straight lines and draw angles. There's a total of eight ships in here, and whatever this is. I don't know what it is. It says Advantage Crayon. Oh, that's a crayon sharpener. I guess you put the crayon in through here and give it a twist, and it, you know, shaves down the crayon. So we'll set that aside. First thing I want to do is take my 9-volt battery, since I don't like leaving them in the games when I put them away. Do the old tongue test. You know how that is. Touch the battery to your tongue, make sure it's good. It looks like somebody already did leave a battery in here. I buy these things used, so who knows where they've been. I'll put the battery in, and I'll turn it on and see if we get a display. And there we go. We got a display. You can see the numbers. Ship number 1, depth 0, north 35, east 25. That's where ship 1 starts. It's facing northeast, and that coincides with the board here. We have ship 1, turn the camera a little bit, ship 1 is at 35 north, 25 east. That's just a quick overview. Now let's get into playing this game. The gameplay of Codename Sector can be very complicated at times. Keep in mind that you're tracking a constantly moving sub with four ships, and each time you go to the next ship, the sub is going to move some more. So once you figure out where it is in relation to ship one, as soon as you go to ship two, it's in a new location, and you're going to have to work a little bit more to try to track its movements. And that's the goal of the game, is to track the movement of the sub. And once you can be absolutely sure that you have one of your four ships within firing distance of the sub, that you can successfully hit the sub. The only major variable is the depth of the sub underwater. You actually have to take an educated guess on how low the sub is underwater when you, fire at it. So instead of just blindly playing this game from scratch to demonstrate the operation of the game, I'm going to follow along on the teach mode that's built into it. There is a teach mode that can be accessed with the teach mode button, and to play in teach mode, you follow along in the manual step by step. You don't deviate from the steps at all, but I will use this to show you how the game is played basically under controlled circumstances. So let's get started. I'm going to have four different colors, the crayons for the ships, and I'll just most likely be reading these instructions off verbatim as I go through them. Now the first thing I'm going to do is ship one is going to be the red color, so I will have my red crayon ready to go. Kind of get some things set up here so I don't lose track, and I'll turn the game on and I'll hit teach mode. I have ship one currently moving at zero speed. Its location is 35 north, 25 east. That would put the ship right here, where it starts out number one. Okay. Right now I know nothing about the sub. First thing I need to do is ask the computer how far away the sub is. And to do that, I press the range button. Range button shows me that the sub is 10 spaces away. Now I need to plot 10 spaces from my current location using the red crayon. Okay, I got my red crayon. Here's where my ship is at. The range said 10 spaces, and that's 10 of the little squares in any direction. One thing I need to note here is you can see a dotted red line, which is basically 5 squares in from the margin of the game board. The sub is not going to leave. It's not going to get outside of that area. It's going to stay within that border. And as the sub's moving, if it's moving along this way, once it gets to the edge, the red dotted line, it's going to go off in one of three directions, either back on itself, off at 90 degree angle, off at 45 degree angle, or if it's coming in at a 45 degree angle, it'll go back on itself, back 45 degrees this way, or back 90 degrees this way. But the sub will continue going in the same direction at all times until it either hits you, or you hit it, or it reaches this red dotted line. So from here, we're going to count off 10 in each direction. Each of these is 5, so 5, 10. So we got 10 here, and it also works diagonally too. 5, 10. Got 10 here. Kind of put a dot. And then 10 this way, and 10 this way. What that leaves us is, ignoring everything outside of the dotted line, we have a range in that area right there. So somewhere along this line is the sub. Now, the sub is exactly 10.10 units away, and these can be counted a certain way. For example, the sub could be here, which could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. You know, 10 steps, whether straight or diagonal, through the blocks. However, we cannot fire at arbitrary angles. We can only fire at 45 degree angles or straight ahead. So if the sub is here, we can't do anything about it. We're going to have to go to the next ship, and then the sub will move to a new location, and the second ship is going to help triangulate the position of the sub. Now that we determined our range, we're going to move our ship closer to the sub. Or at least our best guess is where the sub might be. So let's go back to the computer and enter the appropriate information to move our sub, to tell the computer we're moving our sub. Now, one thing you may notice on this screen is two blinking red dots. That's kind of a screensaver. In a way, actually, it's more of a battery saver. Red LEDs can suck up a lot of power, especially for a little 9-volt battery. So, after about 20 or 30 seconds, it goes into this battery saving mode. It won't automatically shut off because we have a mechanical switch to turn it on and off, but this will help save the battery, you know, for future gameplay. So, what we'll do now, as soon as we press a button, it'll continue from where it left off. The display will light up. So right now, we're going to, let me just hit range one more time. Okay, so it's 10 away. We're currently facing northeast. So we want to move our ship 5 units east. To do that, we rotate our ship by using the steering buttons, and that will steer our direction as indicated by the LEDs on the compass. So we're going to go east. And now we'll press the speed buttons to set our speed to 5. So we're going to head east 5 units. And then I'll hit the move ship button. Our location is now 35 north, 30 east. So now that puts our ship at this spot. So that's our course. We just moved 5 spaces that way. That's our new location. That means we're hoping that the sub could be here, 5 units away, 5 units away, or 5 units away. If we know that the ship is at one of, or the sub is at one of these locations, we can fire or take our best guess. If we miss, we'll be fired at and it'll knock us somewhere else in the ocean. So we don't have enough information for a firing plan. So we're going to have to go on to the next ship. Okay, I'll hit the next ship button. Now we're working on ship 2. It's currently located at 30 north, 25 east, and facing northeast. Now, one thing it doesn't tell us is that the sub moved 1 unit, 1 space. Now, finding out the distance from ship 2 will help us narrow down, if not what space it's on, it could start to give us a general direction that it's headed. I'll start by hitting the range button, and the sub is 11 units away from our current position. Let's plot that. Okay, with a range of 11 from my ship 2 position, I can go out 5, 10, 11, 5, 10, 11. So, remember, I can't go anywhere outside of this dotted red line. So, the sub is anywhere on this green line, because it's 11 spaces, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 5, 10, 11, 5, 10, 11, 5, 10, 11, any which way you count it. the sub is somewhere on this green line. So it moved one space, and obviously it's moving east, or at least east. But is it moving east, northeast, or southeast? One way to find out is to move our ship closer to that line and get another range detection. Okay, we're going to move this ship to the east, so I'll hit right until we're facing east. But we're going to move this one a little faster than the last one, so we're going to move this 9 spaces. And then we'll hit move ship. That sets ship 2 to 30 north, 34 east. And let's check our range here. Now we're 6 blocks away from the sub. So let's plot where our ship 2 is right now. Okay, ship 2 is here. We moved out 9 spaces. It puts us here. And now the sub is 6 spaces away from us. It could be 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It could be between there. Or, let's see. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. It could be there. It could be at any one of these 3 spots. So we narrowed it down from a much larger range to 3 spots. Now we know when we started out with ship 1, it was 10 spaces away, and it put it along this line. So I'm guessing that it was here, and now it either went here, or it went here, or it went here for its one space. And the only way to find out is to continue with the next ship. So we're going to go to the next ship now, ship number 3, which will be the blue crayon. Okay, I'll hit next ship. Ship 3, located at 25 north, 30 east. Now let's check our range. It is 12 units away. Let's count that out. Okay, 12 units away from here is 5, 10, 11, 12. 5, 10, 11, 12. That means the sub is anywhere along this blue line. Now, if it moved one space from the previous one, the only space it could be at, or what that it was at, is here, because that's the only spot it could have been to move one space and still be 12 blocks away from 3. So my guess is the sub started here, went here, and is now here. And it's moving northeast. So let's figure this out. We have another ship coming, right? So when we go to ship 4, it'll be there. When we go back to ship 1, it'll be there. Go to ship 2, it'll be there. Go to ship 3, it'll be there. And we can keep repeating this sequence just to give us a visualization. Black, red, green. You're missing this here. There we go. Now you can see what I'm doing. I'm plotting out the projected future location of the sub based on which ship is next. So that gives us a head start. Now, why can't we fire right now? Well, we can't fire because, as I mentioned before, we can only fire at 45 degree angles or 90 degree angles, or any increment of 45 degrees. We can't fire at an arbitrary angle. So knowing that our sub is here doesn't help us right now, but we can track the sub at least. And then what we need to do is strategically move the ships into position, so when it's that ship's turn, it's in line with the sub, and it can basically have a firing pattern. Now we'll move this ship, ship 3, we'll get it closer to the sub. So we're going to move it northeast, which is the direction it's facing anyway, and we're going to go the full speed we can, which is 9 blocks. So that'll move our ship 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, that'll move our ship to this spot right there. And we'll go back to the computer and do that now. Okay, we're facing northeast, so we're not going to change our steering. We're just going to go up to 9 for our speed, and we'll hit move ship, our new location, 34 north, 39 east, and that's where I had plotted it already. Okay, let's just verify this. Our range is 3 units away. Being 3 units away just tells me something here. I was sort of in the right direction, but I had plotted it wrong. I want to get rid of these dots that I made. It's 3 units away from us, or from ship 3, which means it's going to be most likely here instead of here. So what it probably was is, this is where it was for ship 3. Let's see, 1, 2, 3, silly me, I was counting the wrong way. I was right, 3 spaces. This shows you all the different ways you can count out 3 spaces. 2 diagonals and a straight, a straight, a diagonal, any which way, but it's 3 ways, so yes, it is there. And see, our next ship is going to be black, so I guess I got to go back and put all those lovely dots back in that I drew in before.
And now, these messages.
Berlin's a game that you can play. You can play it 6 different ways.
Some like to play at tic-tac-toe. Others can test their skill at echo.
Some play a tune on music machine or try to play blackjack 13.
Berlin is 6 electronic games in one. It's really fun for most everyone in the family. 6 penlight batteries not included.
With lights and sounds.
6 games in one.
Merlin's a game that's lots of fun.
Merlin, 6 electronic games in one. From Parker Brothers.
Where you going, Susie?
To spend the night at Kathy's.
Bet you're excited.
A little scared too, Milton. I've never slept away from home.
That's only natural. I was nervous my first night here.
Really?
Sure. I didn't know if you'd like Kellogg's Pop-Tarts, but you did. Especially all that real fruit filling and delicious frosting.
Milton, did you ever stay at a friend's house?
Nope. Couldn't find an extension cord long enough. There's a lot of good inside Kellogg's Pop-Tarts toaster pastries.
So all that's back in place. Now we're going to move to ship 4 and see what we can do at this point. Okay, I'll hit next ship. The sub moved 1 space, and we have a general idea where that's going to be. And our range is 13 blocks from ship 4. And we'll go back and plot our course for ship 4 and verify that our projected sublocation is 13 units away. Okay, ship 4 is here, so we have 5, 10, 11, 12, 13. That works. So there's our sub. Now all we need to do is get our fleet to it. Let's figure out a strategy to move. Since we know we can't fire at it from ship 4 here, let's try to put ship 4 in a position that it can fire at it when it's here. Get this back in view here. We can't fire at it here, but we can fire at it here when ship 4's turns come around. So, best way to do that is to move ship 4 a strategic distance. So there's the future location, which then is along this blue line. So that's, let's see, 5, 6, 7. So if we move ship 4 7 units, it'll put us right in line with where the sub is going to be in a future turn. So we'll move ship 4 to 32 north, 42 east, by moving it northeast 7 units. Ship 4 is already headed northeast. We'll set our speed to 7. And we'll move our ship 32 north, 42 east, as predicted. So that puts us in line for ship 4's future turn. And let's verify with the range here. We are currently 6 units away. Going back to the grid, here is ship 4's current location. 6 units away would put it, but the sub, let's see, we think it's there, so it's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and that checks out. That's our sub's position. We can't fire at it right now, it's too far away. So what we can do now is go back to ship 1, which of course would then move it here. Now I'll hit next ship. The sub moved to 39 north, 39 east according to our calculations, and we are, ship 1 is 9 units away. Remember where we moved ship 1 last time? We moved it only 5 units. So 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That's verified. That's where the sub is, and it's 9 units away from 1. Now, unfortunately, we can't move the ship any way to get it within firing range. Firing range is only up to 2 blocks away. We can't go any further, so the best we can do is move 9. So if we moved 5, but it's 9 in one direction, so we can move 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. That'll put us here, but we're 1, 2, 3, 4 away from the sub, so that's why we can't fire in this turn with ship number 1. You know, technically we're close enough to move, but we can only move in one direction. So in this case, we're going to move northeast. We just want to kind of get alongside the sub, so we're going to move northeast 5, 6, 7, 8, and if we move, this is getting out of view again, if we move 8 spaces northeast, 5, 6, 7, 8, that'll put us in line to this dot, which is a future position when ship 1 comes around again. So we're going to move 8 units northeast, which will put us at 43 north, 38 east, and we'll have us 1, 2, 3, a range of 4. So let's do that. Northeast 8 with a speed of 8, and see if it gives us a range of 4 when we check the computer. Okay, we'll change our direction. We'll steer left to northeast. We'll set our speed to 8, and we'll move our ship. There's our 43 north, 38 east, and our range is 4, so that checks out. Now it's time to move ship, or go to ship 2. So we'll hit next ship, which means the sub moved. According to the chart, it's 40 north, 40 east, you know, our pre-plotted chart. Our range from the sub is exactly 10 units, or 10 points. Now what we'll do the same thing we did for ship one. We're going to plot our location to put us in a strategic spot the next time ship two comes around. Okay, since our current location is at 30 north, 34 east, that's right here, we know our sub is at 40 north, 40 east by the way we were tracking it. So we need to get ourselves in a decent position. Maybe we can attempt to fire. We can move, let's see, move diagonals. We can move to here. That puts us within 2 points of firing, or two points away from firing, which is in range. So to move from here to here, we need to go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. We need to move 8 at a speed of 8 northeast. That'll put us there. Okay, change of direction to northeast. And we'll go set the speed to 8 and move our ship. That puts us at 38, 42. Double check our range. Okay, this is something new now. This means we're 2 away and we can fire. We're ready to fire. So we're within firing range of 2 points. Now what we need to do is aim our shot. Now we'll press the aim button, which is right here. Now it's showing that north is blinking. That means that's our current aim position, north. And we want to change our aim. We want to go northwest from where we were as we had plotted. So we'll go to the left here. Oops. Sorry, aim. That's right. We have to keep pressing the aim button for this. Okay. Now we're aiming northwest. Now you can see that we're looking at depth right now. You can see how it goes between 1, 2, and 3 and back up again. This is a possible depth that we can use to hit the sub. We have to choose the right depth, and this is where the guessing game comes in. So is we have to ask ourselves, is the sub at depth 1, depth 2, or depth 3? I'm going to take a guess that it's at depth 1, so when I'm ready to fire, I'll hit the fire button as soon as it gets to depth 1. It's blinking sub, sub, sub. That means I hit the sub. Game over. And that's basically all there is to it. Takes a little bit of minor tactical knowledge. I mean, you don't have to be a naval commander to make this work, but it does take a little bit of thinking. There is some challenge to the game, and from this point here I could probably send the sub off to a new location. I can reset the game, get out of the teach mode here. I'm just going to turn it off and turn it back on again. Now without hitting teach mode, it says here that the sub is 28 points away from where sub 1 initially starts. So compared to the build in teach mode, you know, the sub can be anywhere in a very large range, up to like 40 points away in any direction. You can make it as challenging as you want. If you find yourself getting close to a sub by the range, and you think it was too easy, you see this little evasive sub button here, you actually have to use a pencil or something to point into that. If you press that, let me hit the recall button, show how far away the sub is. It's 28 away. If I hit evasive sub, it's gonna make a liar out of me here too. Maybe I'm not hitting it right. Oh well. That's supposed to let you send the sub off in another direction. Or maybe that's what it does. Maybe when I go to the next ship, it changes directions. But it's a fun game. Now you notice we didn't use any of these subs during the game. This is, when you're playing one player, you won't use these, but these are scoring tokens. I guess you could use them if you wanted to put it on the board to give you a general idea where the sub might be, but these are scoring tokens. So if you're playing two, three, or four players, if you sink a sub, you grab one of these for yourself. That, you know, marks a win. Or if you just like to look at them, you know, put them up here. That's up to you. And this is, you know, if you get this game for yourself, that's up to you what you want to use it for. But Codename Sector, one of the many Parker Brothers games where they, you know, took advantage of microprocessor technology of the late 70s, the same kind of microprocessors that went into other games like, Parker Brothers had a game called Split Second. They also had a game called Merlin, and they all used microprocessor technology of the day, which was simple by today's standards, but it was able to do some, you know, basic thinking, you know, to provide some challenge to you, the player. And make sure you turn off the game when not in use. Nice little reminder written there. And once again, this is Codename Sector by Parker Brothers. And thank you for watching.